Hello everybody, this is Adabizi here, casting for you from wellplayed.org. I'll be bringing you more commentary from MLG Columbus 2011. This will be from the StarCraft II pool play of the seeded players. And this is actually Group C, which was dubbed the Group of Death. So some of the strongest competitors in this pool and in this match, actually, because we've got EG's Idra spawning as the Red Zerg, a very well-known Zerg player. Everybody knows this guy's name. He is quite famous, if not infamous. And his opponent going to be another fan favorite, Liquid's Tyler, spawning as the blue Protoss in the southern position, a staple in the community, one of the pillars of state of the game, hosted, of course, also by JP McDaniel of MLG fame. So we see the first pylon going down, first Overlord heading out. The game is well underway here. Map is Zelnaga Caverns, which is a very standard map, tons of tournaments. This is basically featured in every single serious StarCraft II tournament there is, except for like 2v2 tournaments for obvious reasons. But back to the game, it should be interesting to see what opening Idra opts to go for. Obviously, Tyler going to be throwing down a gateway here and then heading out to scout. Not pylon scouting, as a matter of fact, which will actually leave Idra the opportunity to go hatchery first, and I'm not sure if his overlords might have picked up on that, but he's actually made a 15th drone, and he's heading in with his drone, so it looks like he will be going for a 15 hatchery, a very risky opening, no doubt, but against a player like Tyler, I gotta say it's quite safe. You know, there's many players out there who will, you know what they'll do? They'll cancel all production, make a forge, and start building cannons around your hatchery, but Tyler, he's not really the type, and I think Idra knows that. I think this is a bit of a metagame thing. And Tyler, he's going to need to do something about this. He's going to need to do some sort of aggression, something to put some pressure on, because just letting your Zerg opponent go hatchery first, especially on this map, where they can turn on that aggression switch and really amp up this wide open natural and just get tons of surface area on your units, it can be really difficult as Protoss. So hopefully Tyler's got a solid build in mind here, because it is going to be difficult, especially when you're playing against one of the premier Zergs in the North American scene, because Idra, his macro is immaculate. He just plays so solid. You see this one overlord here making his way across the map. Going to be ready to sacrifice that in if he so chooses. Meanwhile, first Zelda on the way. This drone going to be getting some good scouting in here. Just going to, you know, take a peek. Take a look at how much chrono boost is saved up. Always important to take note of that. And, you know, just delay in general. Possibly see if it's going to be a stalker or a sentry first out of this gateway. We do, in fact, see it is a sentry. So kind of looking like that standard 3-gate sentry expand, but that's a bit risky, especially just with how things have been going lately. Idra is the type of Zerg who does really favor those Roachling Ullins, especially if he thinks there's an opportunity for it. And this drone just continuing to dance around. Meanwhile, two queens in production. And once those two queens get out, Idra is going to have quite a lot of larvae to make as many drones or units as he would like if he does choose to switch his production. Meanwhile, this drone should be dying pretty soon. Probes going in for that little zap, taking out, and boom, two more gateways going down. So it looks like Tyler will be going for the very traditional 3-gateway sentry expand style of play, which I gotta say it's almost becoming a bit dated. Zerg players have kind of really figured out ways to put the pressure on. You can see he's already building a pylon on the low ground. Very important to do. You really need to start off that Sim City very quickly. We've actually seen a lot of Zergs going for basically a 1-gate expand and then building the 2 additional gates on the low ground, because just having the buildings on the low ground really lets you use your stalkers to much greater effect, because of course it's a lot easier to hide from roaches and Zerglings behind those buildings. Meanwhile, Idra with just one guy on the gas right now, so really kind of in macro drone mode, but putting two more guys on gas now. So he might be looking to throw down a Roach Warren soon and amp up that aggression. See, Link Speed not quite done, and he hasn't actually seen that Nexus. He doesn't even see the stuff on the low ground, so not quite time yet to turn down that aggression switch, but actually he is throwing down a Roach Warren, so... Oh, he's also throwing down an Evo Chamber. Very interesting choice. So he might mix in a plus one with this attack as well, which could definitely have a lot of potential. And it's also going to serve the purpose of letting him get some Spore Colonies, or Spore Crawlers, I should say, if he so feels the need. And you see more pylons getting thrown down. Tyler knows he needs that SimCity. He sees the Nexus. And Tyler moving out with a little Huck-style force here, looking to put some pressure on to try and disable any pressure. And you can see Idra actually throwing down a spine, a bit concerning. You know, Tyler could actually be going for a Nexus cancel, which, for those of you who don't know, basically what a Nexus cancel is, you cut probes, you make additional hidden gateways, And then you just cancel your Nexus, warp in an extra round of units, and just go for the gusto. But Tyler, not going to be doing that. Only on three gateways. He's kept up his probe production, and that Nexus will be finishing. So he's definitely playing for more of a macro game here. But Idra, on the other hand, he's also actually looking pretty macro-oriented because he is getting that lair, so not looking to kind of finish off the game too soon. And he sees the three gateways here. He's actually gotten a full scout off with that Overlord, so he knows exactly what's up. Meanwhile, swinging in with the Lynx, trying to cut off those sentries, but unable to do so. Tyler getting back to his base just in the nick of time. And we'll see. It looks like Idra just getting that Roach Warren, mostly for safety's sake. Very interesting there. Not looking to put on any pressure, but looking to kind of imply a bit of pressure possibly, especially with these Zerglings. You don't know what might be following them up. Meanwhile, just back to drone production, adding in his third gas here. Meanwhile, still no additional tech from Ty. Looks like he's just trying to get out as many units as possible now. And, two more gateways here. And will he make even more? Yes, six gateways. So he could be going for a quite early six-gate pressure build. This is, you got to be careful with this kind of build because it's very easy to kind of get ahead of yourself and just not leave yourself any room to keep teching and to keep adding infrastructure if you get these gateways so fast. He's just pumping out lions, and these sentries gonna have a good amount of energy, so Idra will need to be careful, but he's getting roach speed. The plus one Zerg melee attack will be done, helps a ton. You know, when those lings actually get in and connect, they do much more damage. You know, plus one doesn't sound like a lot, but it certainly is. Meanwhile, he's gonna see his opponent start moving out here. Very nice job with these patrolling Zerglings. And how does Tyler want to do this? Does he want to keep pushing in? We also do have Burrow on the way, and Burrow is probably the most essential upgrade here. Tyler will not be able to be aggressive once Burrow finishes. You just can't do it unless you get an Observer out, and he's got no robotics yet, so he's going to have a pretty tight timing window for him to push out, and there's actually no probes pushing forward here, so without a forward pylon, it's going to be very difficult to get aggressive, and Idra boldly going ahead, taking this gold, and heading in for a counterattack as well. Should be able to pick off some probes here. Looks like one Stalker and one Zealot going to be caught out of position. Morlings streaming in after picking off a unit or two there, and he might just be heading right into the main now, trying to get a full skid off, but Tyler, the Lings ninja by the Zealot, just slightly off to the side. And he's like, whoa, what do we have here? Looks like you've got six gateways, my friend. Now, Tyler is adding in robotics, possibly because he's like, well, I can't really be aggressive now. That took too much time. And you can see it's the perfect choice because Burrow's finished. These roaches will be able to pop up and pop down. And you will never be able to kill Zerg when they've got burrowed roaches. And all you've got is gateway units. So good choice there. And he might, you know, he might still put on a bit of pressure just to make sure those roaches are actually out on the field. But I think as soon as he sees these, he's going to need to back off. Going to be very difficult. Nice drop here. And will Idra reveal his burrow? Looks like these roaches are just going to get picked off. And that's quite interesting now because Idra does have burrow. He could have saved those roaches, but I think it's possible that he might just want to act as if he doesn't have roaches to get Idra to commit further. And that's exactly what Tyler's doing. Or to get Tyler to commit further, I should say. Either way, Tyler's still doing a nice job. And you can see Idra not actually burrowing yet. Confusing me a bit, but he might think he has enough units to overwhelm his opponent. I'm not too sure. He does have that full scout off. He hasn't seen the robots. There is an observer on the way now, though, and Idra needs to be careful here. And I'm just amazed not using Burrow at all, but he seems to be holding off this pretty well. The sentries, some with still a lot of energy, but not too much. Gonna be running out of force fields pretty soon. 12 more roaches on the way, baneling speed on the way as well, and plus two melee attacks. Overlord speed is also done, and Tyler's force is just getting worn down here, and the issue for Tyler is he needs to kill this gold. You can't let Zerg just have this gold and you're not on a third base. It just doesn't work well, but there's so many roaches there. Roach speed on creep. These roaches so fast. They're picking off a lot of units. They are unupgraded though, but Tyler actually has not gotten a fort, so his units are completely unupgraded as well, which is a bit troublesome. Meanwhile, he is still on 6 gates. He's cut probes at 38 right now, which is basically saying, well, I'm not really playing much of a macro game, but he is taking out these rocks, so we might see another next come up. Meanwhile, main starting to get a bit dry for both players here, and Idra just massing up, starting to gain a bit of a supply advantage, and he's going to be getting some banelings out soon, and Tyler does see this. He's got this observer parked here, sees everything. Those banelings do have baneling speed, really going to make it difficult to do well with the zealots, and his sentry count, man, he's got zero sentry, so there's not going to be any force fields coming out, so all he's going to have is just dancing units, just some basic micro to deal with that, and that is very tricky. Meanwhile, an overlord once again getting a full scout off. There is a Twilight Council on the way. Whoops, sorry about that camera adjustment there. But yeah, he sees that Twilight Council, so he probably knows, okay, Blink is going to be coming out pretty soon. I want to try and hit before Blink, because there's no sentries out, and my Banelings are going to be pretty good. But still very difficult to engage into this somewhat narrow area. So he's just going to have his units in a forward position to deny any aggression and to let his gold be saturated. Although he could definitely afford to have some more drones there. You know, take drones off your main, put them at the gold, more money. Meanwhile, an infestation pit is on the way. You see these lings at plus two. Banelings with plus two, pretty scary. A good amount of immortals out here, though, and let's see how well these banelings can do. Lings kind of blocking them right now. There the banelings go, crushing a lot of units. And Idra just plowing through this force. The immortals do remain alive. One gets focused down, though. Second one getting focused down, though. And Idra going to be pulling it so far ahead now. Fourth hatchery on the way as well, and this is just not a good position. Hasn't been able to use a Twilight Council, hasn't been able to get Blink. He just has to put all his money into making units and staying alive. Meanwhile, very nice creep hive getting formed, more Banelings getting morphed in, more units just streaming across the map here, and Tyler knows his timing window is closing, his timing to not get utterly, utterly overwhelmed. He knows Idra has that gold base, and it is just a rough spot to be in. Ling's so effective. That plus two upgrade really helping. The Protoss units completely unupgraded. And Tyler is fighting for his life at this point, getting overwhelmed. These Banelings streaming in. These Banelings with plus two will one-shot probes, just so you know. Unfortunately, he's using all of them on the Stalkers. I would love to see some hit the probes. But there's the GG from Tyler. So Idra taking a quick lead in this series here. And I will be heading directly into Game 2. So thanks for tuning in. And do not miss out on game 2, because this is going to be a good best of 3 here. Peace out, guys.